टुडे वी हैव टू डिस्कस दिस फर्स्ट पोर्शन ऑफ द चैप्टर टू दैट इज अबाउट प्रमोशन. ओके एंड हियर वी विल डिस्कस दैट व्हाट इज द प्रमोशन ऑफ द कंपनी एंड हु आर द प्रमोटर्स एंड व्हाट इज द पोजीशन ऑफ प्रमोटर विजेवी द कंपनी. Then the powers of the promoter and duties and liabilities of the promoter, and all these things we will discuss in light of the Erlanger versus New Sombrero Passport Company 1878 in this particular case. Okay. The first thing is that what is promotion? Okay. The promotion is the process by which company come into existence. In the company law, the company took the birth the date that is mentioned in the date of the certificate of incorporation. What section 9 says that from the date that is mentioned in the certificate of incorporation, all the shareholder, the subscriber, and from time being shareholder will become a body corporate, and then further explain can possess property, movable, immovable, tangible, okay, perpetual succession may sue or be sued. And that mean that incorporation is a process by which company come into legal existence. And the whole process through which company is incorporated is known as promotion. Okay, the first thing we have discussed. Come to the second point, the promoter. The promoter, you can understand that the person who actively participate in the promotion. How the company will come into existence? You know, in case natural person, we came in existence because of our parents. Similarly, company come into existence because there were some persons. Kisi ne ye idea hoga ki ye company bana lete hain. फिर मेंबर्स उसने जुटाए होंगे, डायरेक्टर्स के नाम सोचे होंगे, ऑल दोज डॉक्यूमेंट्स हैज बीन अरेंज्ड, हायर किया होगा एडवोकेट का, सीए को या और किसी चीज को, पूरा थिंग्स डिस्कस की होंगी, देन फाइल्ड बिफोर द रजिस्ट्रार, एंड आफ्टर टेकिंग ऑल दोज थिंग्स द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डॉक्यूमेंट, प्रिपेयरिंग द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डॉक्यूमेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू विच कंपनी विल वर्क. सो those persons are in known as promoters. But you know, this definition or the understanding of the word is always very complex and confusing. So in the simple thing, we can say the promoters are the person who bring about the incorporation into the existence. Now here, that whether the advocate who did only in the professional capacity, pe uska to koi role nahi hai. CA, wo bhi professional capacity mein. So some person who acted in professional capacity and has no role in shaping or structuring the company are not promoter. Yani, promoter mein hum wo person hume find karne hai, jo actually company ko shape diya. Okay, so they may be, you know, finally, you know, after that, maybe they became director or the subscriber, or maybe they are not subscriber, but they took the decision. And this is known as promoters. Now, the person who bring together the all the persons who became interested in the enterprise, aid in procuring the subscription, set in motion the machinery which lead to the formation itself, are known as promoters. A promoter is one who undertake to form a company with reference to a given project and set it going, who takes the necessary step to accomplish the purpose. The term as such has no definite meaning. So whether a person is promoter or is not a promoter, it is always a question of fact. But this common understanding that promoters are those persons who participated in the promotion of the company, who decided the structure, who did all the activity when company was not in the force, so that company can come into existence and took the important decision, excluding the person who worked in the professional capacity, are known as promoters. Okay. Now, there is this is our understanding of the word promoter. There is one case, and the name of the case also you can return. There, the judge, learned Judge Bowen, has, gave the statement that what is promotion and who are the promoter. And the name of that case is Ville Bridge Calcico Printing Company versus Green, 1880. If you wish, I can write in the chat box also. Whaley, Ville Bridge Calico Printing Company versus Green. Okay. Here, learned Judge Bowen got the opportunity to define the word promotion and the promoter. And he said that the term promotion is used to sum up in a single word the number of business operations familiar to the commercial world by which the company is generally brought into existence, and the persons who used or who play the role in that business operations are known as the promoter. And so the court gave the function of the promoter, and the function of the promoter come at end as soon as the business of the company, or that it has been handed over to the company's governing body, that means the board of director. Okay. So here the person who is acting in personal capacity are excluded, and all other persons, they may be natural person, they may be juristic persons, who took part, who did all those operations, who all those business operations by which company brought into the existence. Now come to the third stage, that is the statutory definition. The statutory definition has been provided here under Section 2, Clause 69. And Section 2, Clause 69, I just shared the screen. You have Vairact with you also. Screen is visible. Please, any of you read Section 2, Clause 69, that how the legislature has defined the word promoter for the purpose. Because see, in many, yes, I will take your query, Sonali. The word promoters, to the promoters, there are many provision you will find out where there is the responsibility. Like in yesterday class, we discussed Section 7, Clause 6. Section 7, Clause 5, if any person give false information or suppress the information, he is personally liable. Then Section 7, Clause 6, if any member's director gave the false statement or suppressing facts, then promoters will be liable. And so it's very important to find out that who are the promoters. Yes, Sonali? You raise the hand. Anything you want to ask?
No, sir. It's touched by mistake.
Okay, by mistake. Yes. So, Section 269. And this section is divided into three parts. and then excluding certain person who acted in professional capacity. Please, any of you, please read it.
Sir, may I read?
Yes, why not?
69. Promoter means a person A who has been named as such in prospectus or is identified by the company in the annual return referred to in section 92.
Stop now. So clause A is basically having two part. The first is that prospectus, the initial offer, okay, IPO, initial public offer, that, you know, the public company go, and for going into to the public, the company has to give its information, and the document that have the information is known as prospectus. Like, you know, the every institutions, they issue the prospectus. अभी तो ऑनलाइन होता है, जब हमारे समय में तो ऑफलाइन होता था. आपको जब भी एडमिशन लेना होता था, पहले प्रोस्पेक्टस मिलेगा, एंड दिस प्रोस्पेक्टस इज अ डॉक्यूमेंट कंटेन ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ दैट इंस्टीट्यूशन. द प्रोस्पेक्टस हियर इज द सेम विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द कंपनी हैविंग द यू नो इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द कंपनी. सो एनी पर्सन हु वांट टू परचेज द शेयर मस्ट हैव सम नॉलेज, एंड देन सपोज देयर इज एनी मिसलीडिंग स्टेटमेंट और फॉल्स स्टेटमेंट और सुप्रेसिंग, देन देयर आर सम लायबिलिटी. Section 34, 35, 36. Okay. So I'm not going detail. So if in the prospectus there is name of a person, okay, even he has not did, but name is there, law will say that he is promoter. Okay. Whatever I said earlier, that our understanding, like, you know, we discuss cognizable and non-cognizable or bailable or non-bailable. Mostly जो serious offence होते हैं वो cognizable होते हैं, 7 साल तक करते हैं हम लोग. But ultimate is schedule attached to CRPC. If in the schedule it is shown it is cognizable, then now you cannot say तो 7 से कम का है, इसको तो non-cognizable होना चाहिए. तो similarly whatever we have discussed that the person who you know acted, you know, sometimes student ask that if there is the name of a person as a promoter in the prospectus but he did not do, law says section 269 he will be promoter. Okay, the second is that company has to file the annual return, annual you know record under section 92 before the registrar of the company. And in that also has to mention the many things. And in that prospect, you know, the promoters also has to be mentioned. So if it has been mentioned there also, the you know, the promoters, that person would also be considered as, would be considered as the promoters. Okay. Now clause B.
Who has control over the affair of the company? Directly or indirectly, whether as a shareholder, director, or otherwise.
Yes. See the you know the conjunction used is here or in clause A, B, and C. If it would and, then you know all three condition has to be satisfied. उसका नाम भी होना चाहिए और उसका control भी होना चाहिए. But here is the word or, and so either it fall under A or B or C. Who has the control over the affairs of the company directly or indirectly, whether as a shareholder, director, or otherwise. And so here, as a shareholder, the person who having the bulk of the share or you know the large amount of the share or the share by which it can control the affairs of the company. Or similarly, you know, he has the share so that he has been selected as elected as the director, or in the name when the company was registered he was director. Or otherwise means it may be, you know, not in the capacity of the shareholder or is the director, but in his independent capacity, like holder company of a sub company A, then company B, and then company C. So shareholder actually is company B in the C, but A is indirectly having the control in the कंपनी सी, नीदर कंपनी ए इज द शेयर होल्डर नो द कंपनी ए कैन बी नॉट बी डायरेक्टर, सो इन दैट वे सो द कंट्रोल ओवर द अफेयर्स ऑफ द कंपनी. नाउ रीड क्लोज सी.
In accordance with whose advice, direction, or instruction the board of director of the company is accustomed to act.
Okay. So, in accordance of whose advice, direction, or the instruction the board of director of the company accustomed to act. And you know, this portion have the similar or you know, similar definition is under the section 276 clause 7 that talk about related party. Section 272 clause 76 in clause 7, I just shared the screen here. Any person whose advice, direction or instruction a director or manage is accustomed to act it, and again it showing the persons or it want to indicate the persons that have the capacity or whose advice has been taken by the directors, board of the directors in respect to the affairs of the company. So he will be as a promoter. Now the exclusion part, proviso. Please read proviso.
Providing that nothing in subclause C shall apply to a person who is acting merely in a professional capacity.
So this is the proviso excluding all those persons who, you know, took part in the promotion, whose advice was also taken, maybe the board of director also taking the advice, or maybe during the corporation also their advice was taken, who played the very role. Ho sakta naam bhi aapka vakil sahab bada intelligent hai, naam bhi usne soch ke change karwaya ho, but you know, because he did only in the professional capacity, and so you know it they has not been included in the word promoter, because the promoters will have certain you know duties, and there must be certain you know liabilities also, and so that's why you know, because they acted only in the professional capacity, other interests they don't have, and these other person have the interest. So suppose there is any businessman like Mukesh Ambani, he want to form the company. So he convinced 7 student from your class or 6 student from your class also ki chalo business karte hain, bahut acha hai, naam vaam bhi socha, sare document hua, ID card bhi aapka hi le raha, etc, etc. So he is the promoter, you as a shareholder are the promoter, because you also having the control. The person out of you, some 2-3 will be chosen as director, so those will also be promoter. So promoter are all those persons. It is just a the functional definition has been given by the legislature under section 2 clause 69. Okay, now come to the you know certain statutory provisions where there is liability of the promoters. The first is under section 7 clause 5. We already read, so I'm not going to read that. If any person, so as the promoters, or because the promoters has not been written in the incorporation, that that thing is not required, subscriber is required, but as a you know, as a share promoters also, you are also the shareholder, and you give the misstatements, so liability under section 7.5. Then under section 7 clause 6, that very interesting, that maybe the misinformation or suppression of the facts by the members, but the liability is on the promoters. So that thing we have to, or you can write the liability of promoters, section 7.5, section 7.6. Then section 35 clause C, then section 39, then section 300. So these are the some provision where you will find that for you know, certain act, the directors are liable. Like if there is any misinformation, misstatement, then section 35C, the promoters are also liable. Section 35 may क्लोज टू में रिबट कर सकता है दैट आई वाज नॉट अवेयर ऑन ऑल द थिंग बट लाइबिलिटी इज देयर ऑफ द प्रमोटर्स समटाइम द पर्सन हु एक्चुअली यू नो डिड ऑल दोज थिंग्स मे बी ही वाज नॉट इवन चूजन टू बी यू नो द मेंबर्स आल्सो देन आल्सो ही कैन बी प्रमोटर्स ओके सो दिस इज द पोजिशन नाउ वट इज द पोजिशन एंड ड्यूटी एंड वैन वी will be able to find out the position and the duty, then if the duty has not been fulfilled, then there would be liability, the civil liability I'm talking about, you know, that liability under, you can say, the traditional company law or other than the statutory provisions. And here to the position, this case, Erlanger versus New Sombrero Phosphate Company case. This case is in your case material. And in this case, what happened that, just give me 1 minute. This case is in your case material. Please find out this case. There was a group of person, and that group of person has purchased an island. Pura ka pura ek dweep unhone purchase kar liya that was rich of having phosphorus. एंड सो फास्फोरस का तो वो क्या करते सो हाउ टू माइन आउट द यू नो दैट फास्फोरस एंड टू सेल इट दे वांटेड टू फॉर्म ए कंपनी ओके सो ए ग्रुप ऑफ द पर्सन हेडेड बाय वन इंटेलिजेंट पर्सन मिस्टर एरलैंगर फॉर परचेज एन आईलैंड And this island was purchased on a certain price. I'm just telling you the price also. As such, it's not a relevant fact at the 55,000 pound. But it would be important just to find out or just to, you know, find out his, you know, chalaki. Just give me some time. It's, I think, on the 67 page it's there.
82.
82 ना तो 82 में नहीं पुराना वाला नहीं इसमें स्क्रीन वाले पे ये देखो 78 पे आई जस्ट शेयर द स्क्रीन नहीं 78 भी नहीं और कम 77 और समथिंग यू नो अर्लियर आई यूज्ड टू रीड फ्रॉम द हार्ड कॉपी ऑफ द केस मटेरियल दैट आई हैव But then some student raised that, sir, case page number ka wo difference aa raha, toh maine ye liya. Is it visible? There is the case on the page number 69, promoters, duties and liability, Erlanger versus New Sombrero Phosphate. Okay? Yes. Now come to the fact of this case. As I said, that a group of the person headed by Mr. Erlanger, they purchased an island, ek pura dweep unhone khareed liya, jo phosphorus se bhara pada tha. At the 55,000 pound rupees on the 30th August 1871. Date or paise isliye bata raha hu ki inka bada importance hai. And then to mine out the phosphorus and for selling it, you know, Mr. Erlanger wanted to form a company. So he actively participated and he formed, you know, a company. Erlanger named 5 directors in which 2 were abroad. And out of 3 also 2 were directly under his influence. So he was the only director who having the active control over the company. So after the formation of the company, what they did, they transferred the newly company's form. They have the island, then they transferred this island to the company. Okay. And they purchased this island at rupees 55,000 pound. And sold this island to their company only, जो उन्होंने form की है, at double price on the 29 सितंबर 1871, यानी एक ही महीने के अंदर उन्होंने डबल प्राइस पे कंपनी को सोल्ड कर दिया वो पर्टिकुलर थिंग. ओके देन यू नो ऑन द नेक्स्ट ईयर द 1 फरवरी द मीटिंग टुक प्लेस ऑफ द शेयर होल्डर एंड बिफोर दैट यू नो द डायरेक्टर्स मीटिंग इट वॉज डिस्क्लोज दैट दिस आईलैंड वॉज अर्लियर ऑफ अस द एज द प्रमोटर्स एंड वी हैव ट्रांसफर दिस आईलैंड टू द कंपनी. हमने इतने में खरीदा था, इतने में इसको दे दिया. ऑल दैट फैक्ट एंड डायरेक्टर हैव अप्रूव्ड. अप्रूव्ड क्यों कर दिया? बिकॉज इन द डायरेक्टर्स टू वर अब्रोड. डायरेक्टर में सारा आना जरूरी नहीं है, क्योरम हैज टू बी मेंटेन. इन दैट क्योरम यू नो दिस 3 पर्सन, द 2 पर्सन वर डायरेक्टली कंट्रोल्ड अंडर मिस्टर इलेंगर, सो दे हैव नॉट ऑब्जेक्टेड. व्हेन द फर्स्ट मीटिंग ऑफ द शेयर होल्डर हैपेंड एंड देन दे कम टू नो ओह दैट दीज प्रमोटर्स हैव अर्न सो मच ह्यूज प्रॉफिट, दे हैव एन आईलैंड, दे फॉर्म ए कंपनी एंड सो ऑन द डबल प्राइस दे सोल्ड दिस थिंग एंड सो दे वॉन्ट टू टेक द एक्शन. ओके सो ऑन द आफ्टर दिस डिस्क्लोजिंग ऑफ दिस फैक्ट फाइनली द एक्शन वॉज टेकन एंड द क्वेश्चन बिफोर द कोर्ट इज दैट वेदर दीज प्रमोटर्स आर लाइबल विद दिस पर्टिकुलर एक्टिविटी एंड फॉर दैट द कोर्ट हैज टू फर्स्ट फाइंड आउट दैट वट इज द एक्चुअल पोजिशन ऑफ द यू नो दीज प्रोमोटर्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द कंपनी एंड वट ड्यूटी दे हैव एंड इफ दैट ड्यूटी हैज बीन इन्फ्रिंज्ड देन ओनली कैन से दैट दे विल बी लाइबल एंड देन द क्वांटम ऑफ द कंपनसेशन विल बी कैलकुलेटेड और देन यू नो इट वुड बी डिस्कस अबाउट द रेमेडी. In this case, you know, the judgment is given by the 5 judge bench. The 5 judges, you know, these lords you will find. And this first para, there it is visible in on your screen. This first para, the position of the promoter up to this bold word appeal. This is about the, you know, the position of the director vis-a-vis the company. When you will read these lines, it would be very clear to you that what is the position of the director, but I'm not going directly into it. Then the first Lord Carrion has said, and Lord Carrion has said in this particular case, Irlanger versus New Sombrero, that the position of the promoter is that they stand into a undoubtedly fiduciary position. Fiduciary position. What is the fiduciary position? The Merriam-Webster dictionary define that the fiduciary relationship is a relationship in which one party plays special trust. It's not only trust, the special trust, confidence, and reliance in and is influenced by the another who has the fiduciary duty to act for the benefit of the party. And here, those persons who worked, who do, did all those business operation by which company came into the existence, have that fiduciary position, that special trust they must have. And they have in their hand the creation and molding of the company. They will get many opportunity to cheat the company, to make the profit from the company. Okay? And they have the power of defining how and when, in what shape, and under what supervision the company shall start and will come into the existence and being be a trading corporation. And so the business of the promotion gives a very advantageous position to these promoters in relation to the proposed positions. Okay? And so the chief duty of the promoter as a fiduciary agent in is to disclose to the company their position, their profit, their interest in the property which is subject to be proposed. Purchase or sold by the company. Okay. Now, Lord Millet has observed in the another case, Bristol and West Building Society versus Matthew, about the position of the director or the fiduciary position, that a fiduciary is someone who has undertaken to act for and on behalf of another, as we read in the Merriam-Webster dictionary. So to act and on behalf of another in a particular matter in the circumstance which give rise to a relationship of trust and confidence. In English common law, it is an important concept within the part of legal system known as equity. And the conduct of fiduciary may be deemed to be constructive fraud. Maybe it is not fraud, but constructive fraud when on the basis of the act, omission or concealment of the fact would be considered as if, you know, fraudulent. So the only difficult question is when to disclose and before whom it has to be made. Okay, now any of you read these few lines that is in the cases before this appeal. These few lines on the first para, from this word, the position of the promoter, up to this bold word appeal, is about the position of the promoter. Yes, please, any of you read it. Dikh raha hoga na screen pe?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, read it.
The position of promoters vis-a-vis the company which they are promoting is not that of trustees to a statutory trust, but they are in a fiduciary position towards the company.
Yeah, stop. So the court is saying that the position of the promoter with respect to VJV, means with respect to the company which they are promoting, is not that of the trustee. Wo trustee wali nahi hai. Trustee is QA trust, but rather in the fiduciary, the special trust confidence that is there. Yes. Now read where the promoter.
Consequently, where the promoters of a company sell property to the company, the burden is on them of showing that they have not taken any unfair advantage resulting from their...
Yeah, another very heavy line, that the burden is on the promoter to show that they have not taken any undue advantages. Yes, read further.
It is their duty to nominate independent directors of the company who are capable of acting impartially in defense of company's interest and will be competent and impartial judges whether or not the purchase ought to be made.
Furthermore, yes. So in these lines you will find that the position of the promoters vis-a-vis the company is clear, that it is even more than the trustee. They have the fiduciary position, and the fiduciary position have its meaning, like the Lord Millet has observed in the Bristol and West Building Society versus Matthew case, and the Merriam-Webster dictionary, that is the special trust or the confidence by which one person acts on behalf of the other. And the only question left is that to whom they have to disclose their position, because the contention of these persons as a promoter in Langer, that we made all these facts disclosed before the board of director. Okay, and board of director have approved. If board of director approve kar diya, then it is perfectly valid. We have fulfilled our duty. Okay, and then, you know, this second para, from this word appeal to this, the plaintiff in the action of the chancery. Appeal se pehla para hai na, jahan appeal bold line mein hai. This is about the case history. The case history hai. That the first case, then it was decided, then the appeal was reversed, and then the Erlanger reached to the, as a plaintiff, to this court. Then in the third para here, that the plaintiff in the action in chancery division. This third para is about the facts. Okay, so first is the position of the promoters vis-a-vis company. The second para, this appeal, starting from this bold line appeal, is about the case history, leak law. And the third para is about the facts. This third para will run even into the next page. And up to the next page, where next para started, this all about the facts of this case. And these facts are, I think, sufficient. Now you will find the judgment under the different lords had. The first judgment is Lord Carrion. That you will find after these on the page number in this, the 71. And Lord Carrion, you know, the first para and the second para. The first para itself is about, again, you know, deciding the position of the director. And he, whatever earlier I read, that undoubtedly in the fiduciary position, etc., I have picked up from here. So here, you know, fourth line, the third line, they stand, in my opinion, undoubtedly in fiduciary position. They have had in their hands and creation. So all these things I pick up from this particular thing. So this portion. Then, you know, you have to read the second judge judgment, this Lord Hathley. And in the Lord Hathley, you have to read the para number, first para of Lord Hathley, first and the second para. Okay. And no need to read, you know, other thing also, because that is in itself is sufficient. But if any of you find the comfortable, they can go through the whole case also. But jo lazy hain, and the person who cannot read this whole case, at least read these four things, five things. The first para about the fiduciary position. The second para is about case history. The third para is about the facts. Then the first para under the Lord Carrion judgment. And then the first para about the Lord Hathley judgment. Itna padh lo, this topic will be clear about the position. Okay. So in this case, finally, the court, you know, it was held that they are in the fiduciary position. But the question is that whether they have, you know, breached their duty or not. Because they have to disclose all these things that already written in the first para. Because when you are in the fiduciary position, that is your duty to, you know, disclose. And court said that it will not be enough to disclose the truth to the first directors, where in, you know, actual position, the directors, two directors were absent, and out of five, two directors were absent. The two directors were directly under the influence of Mr. Erlanger, and Erlanger as a promoter in that capacity has done. And so disclosing to the first board of director will not be sufficient for, you know, fulfilling the duty of the promoter. And they have to make these facts clear, or they have to make this fact disclosed before the first meeting of the shareholder. The disclosure should be made to the whole body of the person who are interested to become the share, you know, the shareholders. And so it has to be disclosed before the body of the shareholder as independent. Because in this case, the body as a director were not independent. So that is the decision of this case. Now, have you got this case? Have you understood this case? Any question so far? Kisi ka koi question puchi? Puchna hai? Sonali?
थोड़ा पढ़ के और क्लियर हो जाएगा।
Okay. Now there is one another case that is not given provided. You can write the name of this case also. You will find in the books. Gulkastein versus Barron. I will write in the chat box. I just take 5 minutes and then this topic will be over. Gulkastein versus Barron and this is I just written the names 1900 AC House of Lord. What happened in this case? The facts of this case are that there was a syndicate, means the group of the persons, like here Erlanger, and they purchased the property at rupees 1,40,000 pound. Okay, and then they form a company and sold this property to the newly formed company. Okay, and in the prospectus they disclose that there was this particular property that as a promoter has purchased at this particular price, and then they have transferred this property to this newly formed company at the price 1,80,000. So 40,000 का profit उन्होंने बनाया था, लेकिन they have disclosed in the prospectus. तो जो भी shareholder देखना है वो भाई देख ले, ये चीजें हैं. Okay. Lord Halsbury, learned judge here, said that the question arose that whether this type of the disclosure is perfect or not, because in the Erlanger versus New Sombrero Phosphate Company case, the it was decided that the disclosure should be an independent body who can take the decision, and that body of director was not independent body. Disclosure of the facts by the promoter should be before the body of the persons who are invited to become the shareholder, who have the interest in the company, and here it has been fulfilled. Then also, the case has been filed that the these promoters have breached their fiduciary duty. So the Lord Halsbury said that disclose to the parties to this transaction does not amount to disclose to the company. The duty continues even after the incorporation or until the profit are fully disclosed and fully accounted for. And section, fully accounted for and fully, disclosed means that maybe the persons who in the prospectus know this fact will choose not to become the members. And so it's not that when they disclose this fact into the prospectus, they have fulfilled their duty. After becoming the members also, they have to disclose this fact. And if there is the breach of the duty, they are the liable. Okay. And what is the liability? That they have to make good to the company. Whatever profit they have earned, they have to return back to the company. So that is their due, their liability. So the position of the promoter we have discussed, the duty we have discussed, that they are duty bound to disclose every fact, and the burden is in them. And if they are failed to do, this type of the omission, then it will be treated as the fraud with the company. And then the liability that they have to make as a civil liability, they have to make the profit. There are some other statutory liability also, section 7 clause 6, section 35C, section 300, etc. So with this, today we have only discussed this particular topic of the promotion, that what is promotion, who are the promoters, what are their position with the company, what the powers they have all the powers to mold and structure the company, they have the duty, that fiduciary duty, and they have to disclose everything, their act may amount to the fraud, and their liability, non-statutory liability also, and the statutory liability also were expressly written under the Companies Act 2013. So with this, today class is over. If you have any question, you are welcome.